Dear students, in our daily life, we come across many processes. For example, when we prepare a cup of tea, we boil water, or we freeze water into ice cubes. We see rusting or the curdling of milk. These processes are classified as physical or chemical processes. Now, what is the basis of this classification? Let us see. Physical processes are those which involve change of physical state, but the chemical formula remains same. The examples, like we melt ice into water or we heat water to change into vapors. In all these examples, only the physical state is changing. The solid ice is changing from the solid state to the liquid water, or on heating, the liquid water is changing into vapors. Only the state is changed, but the chemical formula remains same, that is H2O. But in the chemical process, the chemical formula is changed. Let's see a few examples. Combustion of graphite. Carbon plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide. You can see the change in the formula. Another example, decomposition of calcium carbonate or decomposition of ammonia. In all these examples, you can see that the reactants and the products have the different chemical formula. So, all those processes in which a new thing is formed, they are chemical process. Today, our main focus is on the chemical processes in which there is a transformation of energy. For example, the energy is released in the form of heat or electrical energy or mechanical energy, or you can say a sound energy. For example, when we heat carbon or its compound, we see that heat energy is released. When we burn magnesium ribbon, the energy is released in the form of light. When we burn crackers, the energy is released in the form of heat, light, and sound. In your daily life, you use dry cell in your remote or in the torch. The chemical energy stored in the dry cell is converted into electrical energy. Thermodynamics. Thermodynamics is the branch of science which deals with the quantitative relationship between these different forms of energy. The conversion of heat into work and work into heat. Thermodynamics. There are two words, therm and dynamics. Therm means heat, dynamic means movement. Thermodynamic deals with the flow of heat during a process, physical or chemical process. Thermodynamics is a physical science that deals with the quantitative relationship between heat and other forms of energy. It interrelates macroscopic variables such as temperature, volume, and pressure and amount of substance. The release of heat in a chemical process is due to the making and the breaking of bonds. The heat may be released or absorbed. It depends on the strength of the bonds in the reactants and the products. The thermodynamics is based on some real-life generalizations, and these are known as the thermodynamic laws. There are first, second, and third laws of thermodynamics, and later there was one more law, that is zeroth law. So there are four laws of thermodynamics which we will study one by one. The zeroth law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, and third law of thermodynamics. Before studying about the thermodynamic parameters, let us know about the thermodynamic terms which we need to understand all these thermodynamic parameters. To understand the thermodynamic parameters, we must know and understand the thermodynamic terms which are used in these thermodynamic parameters. In thermodynamics, we divide the universe into system and surroundings. System is that part of the universe which is under thermodynamic consideration. For example, if we are doing an experiment in a beaker or a test tube, then that beaker or test tube is the system, and the rest of the universe is surroundings. Here I want to explain that the whole universe is not regarded as surroundings because it is not interacting with that test tube or the beaker. Only that part of the surrounding which is interacting with the system is known as the surroundings. And there can be a real or imaginary boundary between system and surrounding. Types of systems. The systems are classified as open, closed, and isolated system. Let me explain you one by one. Open system. This is a beaker and it is open from the above and the walls are thermally conducting. Suppose there is water in this beaker and I heat this water using a burner. Then the flame and the heat, the water will be heated in this beaker, and after some time the water vapors will go into the upper atmosphere. So you can see that there is an exchange of heat from the surroundings to the system and the water vapors will come out. So you can see that there is an exchange of matter and energy between the system and the surroundings. This is an open system. In an open system, there is exchange of energy and matter between system and surroundings. Closed system. Now, for example, again that same setup, water in it, but I close this with the help of a watch glass. Now, the water vapors will not go out in the atmosphere, only the heat from the flame will heat the water. There is only the exchange of heat energy or energy, but there is no exchange of matter between the system and the surroundings. This is a closed system. In a closed system, there is no exchange of matter, but exchange of energy is possible between system and the surroundings. Isolated system. This thermos flask is an example of isolated system. The walls are insulated and the cap is also insulated. Neither the heat from inside the flask can go out, or not the heat from the surroundings can go inside the thermos flask. Also, it is closed from the above, and matter can also not be exchanged between the system and the surrounding. This is an example of an isolated system. No exchange of matter and energy between the system and the surroundings. In an isolated system, there is no exchange of energy or matter between the system and the surroundings. To describe the state of a system, we have to specify some macroscopic properties like pressure, volume, temperature, number of moles of the substance, that is the amount of the substance, and the composition. These are known as the state variables. If there is any change in any one of the macroscopic property, then there is a change in the state of the system. These are known as the state variables. Today, we have studied that in a chemical process, either there is evolution or absorption of energy. It is due to the making or the breaking of the bonds. We have also studied about the system and the surroundings. Together, they form the universe. And the system are of many types, for example, open, closed, or isolated systems. In the next class, we will study about the different thermodynamic parameters. Thank you.